My name is Alicia Cobb. I'm a professional full-time artist. I was born and raised in Stamford, Connecticut. Stamford was a really diverse city, which I really appreciated being biracial. Me and my brothers, we definitely stuck out, but we also fit in at the same time. So it was actually a really humbling place to grow up and experience childhood. We actually grew up in the projects of Stamford, so things were a little different. We experienced a lot of things that maybe, you know, your average kid in suburban communities didn't experience, but we never felt unsafe or, you know, we never felt unsafe. Home was home, and we played outside and we ran and we just did what kids do. I went to West Hill High School in Stamford. Honestly, I did not like high school, ever. I finally decided in my senior year that I was actually going to actively participate. I did not like high school prior to my senior year. I took art classes there. I had a few friends. I was not antisocial, but I was kind of a wallflower, didn't really talk to a lot of people. Kind of stayed to myself. I was a loner, for sure. That's funny, because I actually had my daughter 1 year after I graduated high school. So I decided not to go to college. I used my daughter as an excuse to not go to college because at the time, it seemed like I wouldn't be able to do both. I went into customer service positions and worked a lot of different odd jobs here and there just to make ends meet, take care of my daughter. I started taking an at-home art course when she was an infant, just because I knew I wouldn't be able to go to college, so I figured if I did something at home. But I started painting people, just face painting. I was face painting kids, and I actually did that because I had social anxiety. I have a huge family, and every year they had this big Super Bowl party, and 250 people show up. And I literally didn't want to talk to any of them. They're my family and I love them, but it gave me anxiety to talk to them. So I would park myself on the bleachers and all my little cousins would line up and get painted. After a few years of doing that, I mentioned to a friend who was building his photography portfolio that I would love to paint a person's body, but I didn't know it was a thing. It was something that was in my head. I thought it was a little crazy, but I figured I might be able to find somebody that might be interested by it. He found a model. He said, the deal was, you find a model, you know, I'll find a model, you let me do the photography. And so that was in 2009. I painted a full body. Her name was Lolly, my very first body. She's like a veteran, she gets painted all the time. But the pictures hit the internet and I haven't stopped painting bodies since. I just did a huge body art show a couple weeks ago right in Bridgeport. I have a studio space at 305 Knowlton Street in Bridgeport. And we did a show called Unframed, Unframed because it was body art. It was all performances where the art comes to life. And they basically came outside of the frames and did what they did. We had singers, we had dancers, we had a bodybuilder, we had a little bit of everything. But the production itself touched on the human spirit, you know, and what we deal with every day. The first half of the show focused on just being human, dealing with depression, dealing with brokenness and brokenheartedness and the things that we have to do every day as human beings. The second half of the show focused on bringing people together, unity, healing. And for me, it's really important as an artist to convey those things, the idea of coming together, unity, using our art to actually forge positive change is something that's really important to me as an artist. My next thing that I'm working on is a black and white art show. It's a collective art show, a bunch of local artists from Bridgeport. It also is gonna double as my 40th birthday celebration.